everyone. My name is Sarah Kustok, and welcome to the Blue Demon Exchange. I was fortunate enough to play on the DePaul women's basketball team, had a brief stint as an assistant coach with head coach Doug Bruno on the women's program, and of course, most importantly, a student athlete. I was able to earn my bachelor's degree in communication, my master's in corporate and multicultural communication, and DePaul University is such a special place for me, as is the women's basketball program. So with that being said, I am so excited to welcome in the head coach of the women's basketball team, Doug Bruno. And Coach Bruno, it's so good to see you. I know we'll get to how the DePaul family is doing, but how are you and your family doing during this time?
We're doing very well, Sarah. And it's I really believe that in life, you got to take any situation that comes your way and make the most of it. And what I miss the most is I miss the interaction, the daily interaction with my staff and my players. But the benefit is every other aspect of the job you find out you can do from home. So we are able to spend time at home, and Patty and I have probably spent more time together than we've spent since our honeymoon. I say that, it seems like it's facetious, but really, when you think about it in life, people get married, they go on their honeymoon, they come back and they go to work, and you're never this much together. And it's really kind of been fun to work from home.
Yeah, I know this global pandemic is impacting everyone and doing so in so many different ways. But I think about you, I think about the women's basketball program and how you have set a standard for success each and every year. So with that being said, during these circumstances with players back at home or scattered all across the country, how have you helped to sustain that on the court, in the classroom, all of those type of things that you normally are doing hands-on with your players during this time?
Well, first of all, we have a lot of help. I've got a great staff. We get together with the players live on the Zoom at least a couple to three times a week. And we'll have team meetings. We also have the players interacting with each other, both in larger groups and smaller groups. And then we as coaches are interacting amongst ourselves. You know, we have one-on-one meetings with our players as well. It's not the same, but at the same time, it does provide you an opportunity to be looking at one another. And it's probably taking us 2-3 weeks to get in the swing of it all.
I know you had mentioned the staff and the weekly meetings and things that you guys are trying to do, but do you feel like you, in person, were able to adequately say goodbye before the stay-at-home order was put in place, say goodbye to staff, to players? The last time I saw you guys was as you were being crowned champion of the Big East tournament. And it's amazing how quickly things changed throughout the course of the next week or two. But what was it like trying to say goodbye once everything started to be put into place?
Well, first of all, we were one of the lucky, I think, 9 leagues we were able to finish. So we were, one of 9 teams that actually qualified for this year's NCAA tournament. So we could actually say we made the tournament this year. But back to the players, you know, it was a tough, because the 2 seniors, Shante Stonewall, Kelly Campbell, and the entire team, but specifically those 2 seniors, I think they're really, really poised as seniors to lead this team into what would have been their 4th straight NCAA tournament. But really, we're really poised to try to make some noise.
One of your former players, Brooke Schulte, is a nurse in the ER and, of course, on the front lines and helping to try and keep us healthy and safe. What does that mean for what not only Brooke has done for the program, but what she's giving back here to all of us?
Brooke's just a great example of DePaul, of what a DePaul person is. I mean, Brooke is a giver. I mean, she became the Big East Player of the Year in 2017. She averaged 8 points a game just January, gets injured. So Brooke's got to step up. So she goes from 8 points to 23 points. Her career ended. She did not want to go play in Europe. She did not, I mean, she would have played in the WNBA had she been drafted, but she wasn't. So she wanted to be a nurse. She it's hard to become a nurse when you are an intercollegiate athlete. It's one of those majors that requires clinicals and being in hospitals all day long. And I know there's some out there that have been able to pull it off, but it's not easy. Ironically, Peter Raybush, who is Lisa's son, Peter, who played at DePaul also, he also got his master's degree in nursing. So Brooke and Peter are working together down at Northwestern in the ER. And know, this is both of their first jobs, and they knew they wanted the ER. They applied for the ER. They got accepted at the ER, but they weren't expecting this kind of action in the emergency room.
Shout out to one of my best friends, former teammates, your former players, Jamie Smith, who is up in Alaska. A nurse. She's not in the ER, but she's helping out as well. So, Coach, it is always such a pleasure to get an opportunity to see you, and certainly different and unique under these circumstances. But thank you so much for taking the time. Know how much we and all of us appreciate it and appreciate you.
Sarah, thanks for all you do for DePaul, and thanks for all you do for women's hoops. I mean, I know we're so proud of you. You're giving up a lot when you choose to walk away from an NBA game to do a women's college game. It's very much noticed and appreciated.
Well, never, never, never forget your roots, and that's something I will never do. So thank you so much, Coach, again. And, of course, this has been another Blue Demon Exchange. We're going to have more coaches, student-athletes, administration on having these beautiful chats to connect. So until next time, stay home, be well, and take care, DePaul.